What's up, family? We back with another video. So, you don't need to turn to go back down. So, if you're just now tuning in, I am Sky, and this is Wesley. If you do not, oh, Jesus fixes. Can you leave the job to me? All right, so.
Have you seen it, bro? It is wet.
I wouldn't be making that noise. All right, y'all, so. If you live in Charlotte or the surrounding areas, you probably already know that it is Charlotte Black Restaurant Week. Well, instead of it being 2 weeks because of COVID, they're going to do Instead of it being 1 week like last year, they're going to do 2 weeks. And this year, I think they have about 15 businesses. Last year, they had probably about 30. Well, when I was talking to the lady at Hip Hop Smoothie, who's also on the list of Black restaurants, she was telling me that most of the businesses went out. I mean, they're closed down because of COVID, so the list is very limited. So today we're going to go to the Nappy Chef, actually, on Albemarle Road. We're going to go there for brunch because I got a taste for chicken and waffles. And it's located at 5933 Albemarle Road, and that's near like Independence. Now again, I've never been here before, but it's on the list, so I want to go. And they're open until 8 p.m. today, which is a Sunday. Oop, that website not working. Let me go to their Facebook. I'm trying to find what they specialize in so I can tell y'all. Ooh, Nappy Chef's got $5 wing baskets. So the whole purpose of the Black Restaurant Week is they're going to basically provide specials and discounts throughout the 2 week span so people can, you know, it's a working fire, 455 Newport Drive. So the whole purpose of the Restaurant Week is to bring awareness to the Black restaurants and the communities, and to also promote their special dishes that they have that they don't normally have. Like, I know I went to a restaurant last week, and they were giving out stuff they don't normally give out. And they said they were trying to put it on the menu. So the list is about 15 restaurants, and today we're going to go to the Nappy Chef. And I'm going to try to go to, like, two more this week. But once we get there, I'll show you guys what it looks like. And...
Chelsea
switching. He done turned on football, and I was looking at the. Get to the football.
Why is she driving like this?
I don't know. How about you call an accident?
She out of control.
This car out of control, driving in two lanes. So yeah, we'll be back once we get to the restaurant, so you guys can see what it looks like. Until then, toodle.
Waffle House.
You said what?
It's a Black Waffle House.
You said his wife shot at him? Jesus. I left my tripod. All right, y'all. So we gotta wait like 15. Don't move the table. The table wobble.
Are you telling them that or telling us?
Y'all. So we gotta wait like 15, 20 minutes for our food. It better be 15. As a matter of fact, what time is it?
I didn't even ask. They told you that? They didn't give me the time.
Okay. So she placed my order at 2:28. So she got 15, 20 minutes. So this place is jumping like Jordan.
It's probably going to be about 30.
Yeah, it's probably going to be about 30. I don't even know why her self-esteem so high. But.
So for some reason, I don't know if it's because of COVID or not, but that's not really the reason, because my friends came.
We tried Stats first. They wanted us to eat on our lap. We might as well sat on the floor. Like,
they tried and they were serious too. They was
They was like, oh, you got a table? Sir, where? You mean this little,
I'm talking about the little end
the
table.
The little coffee table? You got a coffee table?
Talk about the end table. The one saying, yeah, y'all gonna pick us the end tables.
Like, what? What did you do that? I've never been treated that way in my whole life. It be your own people sometimes. It be your own people.
You didn't say nothing? What's he over it? Like when he doesn't get, when he's hungry, he doesn't even want to talk.
So. I was forced to talk.
You picked this place.
We picked this place. You see how black people do?
I said let's go to Red Eye.
And did they answer the phone? No. Is it black owned? No.
No, they're not. But at this point,
you see where her true allegiance is lying.
Right. Like what?
I was hungry, so
we were on the way out in the mist and cold.
No, when I feel the first drop.
It's not even raining no more.
But I said when I feel the first drop. I'm gonna show y'all what the patio looks like. Let's do that since we got 15-20 minutes.
I said, I'm waiting for my food and it's for here.
So this is the.
Your camera don't flip.
Yeah, it does, but I ain't doing all that.
Alright, so we got our food. And it's good.
That's our special guest. So I got the special, the boss plate.
Yeah,
I got the special boss plate.
Food over the line was too long.
I got the salmon Philly, jerk mac, and the mambo wings.
And I got the chicken and waffles with lemon pepper for my wings. Now, Wesley, you said something like they didn't put the sauce on the wings because of what?
No, I got sauce on my wings. They said on the breaded wings they don't put sauce on the breaded wings. So I'm going to try this jerk mac because he said it's their signature dish. That's good.
So our special guest is not in the camera because she already devoured her food. So that's why she's not, you can hear her, but her food is gone. So
I got 3 wings left.
Jerk mac is good. It's just a...
They're not hot though.
It's just a different... It's mac and cheese. It's good mac and cheese. It's got a different flavor to it.
I'm gonna try it. This one's good.
Fries are good.
I don't know who wings are better. These are the ones from that. Whatever that place is called, we went to.
Stats.
So yeah. Oh. I got fruit punch. I'm gonna tell y'all if it's actually like fruit punch or like Kool-Aid. I think it's gonna be Kool-Aid. It'll stick to the theme if it's Kool-Aid.
Shut up. And they got quality napkins. He's not that regular.
Yo, this is Kool-Aid.
Why are you yelling?
It still tastes good.
Yeah. It's Kool-Aid.
Thank you. I'm so glad that it's Kool-Aid and it sticks to the theme of the restaurant.
What's the theme of the restaurant, Chelsea?
Nappy Chef.
So I'm assuming Chelsea doesn't like the name of the restaurant.
So we got a mumbo wing here.
Yeah, I'm listening. Sorry.
It's good. It's got that sweet, salty, sticky texture.
This bone here.
Yeah, that's all she got.
literally all she got. All right, so we're done eating.
As you see, my jacket can't fit anymore.
All right, so what would you, Chelsea, you're our special guest, what would you rate the food?
It was a good out of 10. It was a good 7.
Okay, customer service.
Customer service was great. I thought she was really nice, very helpful. She was busy.
Appearance.
Customer service is about She didn't have on a mask, so she get one. She had no mask on.
Okay, okay.
I didn't appreciate that.
Restaurant.
Maybe she voted for Trump.
Oh, God, Jesus.
It's quite possible.
Okay, okay.
Make sure you get out of there early.
Okay, restaurant appearance.
What you give it that? I thought it fit the theme. I appreciate the theme of the...
Well, what is the theme, Chelsea? Why are you saying the theme? What is the theme?
So the place is called the Nappy Chef. And when you think of the word nappy, you think of ethnic. When you think of ethnic, you think of hood baby, little baby.
She not invited no more.
And it was real good.
We gotta watch us there.
Maybe the lady at the thing. Maybe the lady at the counter is an anti-masker.
Maybe, but
Wesley, I'm done with Chelsea. What do you think?
No, it was great overall. Okay, all seriousness.
They about to slap your car overall.
And I'm about to get this money. Okay. I had a great experience. I like that they were playing hip hop music. I like that I got exactly what I expected just from the name of the restaurant. It was good. It was good.
All right, now that we're in a heated car, because it was cold up, we can give our review. So I'm going to give mine. I really want Wes to give his first, but he not. But I feel like his review always be based off my review. Like, bro. But, neither here nor there. I would give the appearance. It wasn't the location is not bad. It's right in the middle of tomorrow, so it's a busy road, so the location was good. I give the customer service a 7. She was really polite, even with it being so crowded and hectic. She didn't give attitude, and you know that type of stuff matters. Like, some people, when they get overwhelming, they take it out on the customers if it's our fault that it's crowded. But she didn't do that. She did a really good job with, you know, keeping her cool, keeping her patient, and staying professional. So I give her a 7. The food. Was you about to say something?
If she did so good, how was that a 7? What did she do bad?
She didn't do nothing bad.
Oh, okay.
But she not a 10.
Okay.
I already told you I don't give 10s. 10s is perfection and no one's perfect.
So that means you can't get
She didn't have on a mask. Boom. 3 points off.
Maybe she an anti-masker.
Like, she didn't have a mask on. That got her 3 points.
Maybe she's an anti-masker.
But she was good. She was okay. I mean, she really wasn't much for her to really do. I mean, you come up, place your order. That's that. Like, there wasn't nothing spectacular about what she did. So, the food, it came out in a decent time. Like, even with it being really, really crowded, it still came out in a decent time. I think it took like 23 minutes for my food to come out, I think. So for me, that wasn't bad. You're gonna make that left up there, sir.
Yeah, I know where I'm at.
How you know where you at? So the food came out, it was good. It was the chicken was fresh. Lemon pepper was really good. It was a little on a salty side, but I just think lemon pepper is salty anyway. If I'm not mistaken, lemon pepper is salty. So, I mean, that's expected. The waffles were banging. The waffles were good. The fruit punch, let me tell y'all, I have not had Kool-Aid in God knows how long. And they can't tell me that was not Kool-Aid. It was good. So, overall, I'll give them a 7. Wesley?
Mm-hmm. What do you want to know?
What you rate them? Come on now, this ain't our first episode. Get with the program. Appearance. Start with appearance. You're going to turn right at Sharon Emily.
Yeah, it's right here. I told you I know what I'm at. Just didn't want to drive in the bus lane.
Appearance. What do you give them for appearance? Basically like location and how it looks.
I mean, it's more like a neighborhood type spot vibe on the interior. So I give them a 6. It is a small place. It's not very big. Not that it has anything to do with appearance, but, you know, it's cool. It's cool. The interior is a lot similar to Lulu's.
Mm-hmm. So if you did not watch our video from 2 weeks ago, you need to go watch it so you can know what Lulu's look like on the inside, because they're also listed on the Charlotte Black Restaurant Week. Go ahead, finish.
Okay, what's next?
Okay, appearance. Customer service.
Oh, she get a 9.5 because she probably thought I was cute.
Bro, she didn't even do anything. You told her your order and that was that. What did she do? First of all, she forgot my sauce.
I'm just saying.
A 9.5. I would, ooh, if you was not driving.
I'm just saying. I look good.
What does that got to do with her customer service, sir?
Next subject.
Score the food.
Food, so I don't know if he's making his sauces homemade. He has a couple sauces on there that obviously will have to be homemade. He got some Hennessy sauces, some Henny sauces. I had some mumbo sauce, so either he's getting somebody to fly him mumbo sauce from DC, or he's making it himself.
Or he could be from DC.
Well, then he still have to make it himself.
Yeah.
Which, that's a good thing, because when you're making your own sauces, now I know, you know what you're doing. The mumbo sauce was really good. It was sweet. It was sticky. It had a slight background heat, which now he's making it. If he made that one, now he's making a layer sauce, which is hard to do. So that was pretty good. The jerk mac, it was solid mac and cheese. I wouldn't say it was phenomenal mac and cheese. It was solid, but the twist, it had a twist, which was his jerk flavor. I think there was some chicken in there. So that was good too. The jerk mac actually brought it a little bit higher than average. The mac and cheese was average, but the jerk twist and that chicken kind of really bumped it up, so it turned into a really good dish. And what else I have? The salmon Philly. The salmon Philly was a solid sandwich. I think it had too much cheese on it, but other than that, it was a solid sandwich. Also, I think the cheese made it a little bit too salty, but I think it was obviously from the cheese. So
overall, with appearance, food, and customer service, what would you overall score them?
So the food, I'm gonna give.
Any left lane to go on WTR?
The food, I'm gonna give a 7. Just cause.
Oh, you gonna kill me? It's up there. Ain't no car right there, so you can just.
Car sure. Right there. So overall, I'm gonna give a 7, because I personally don't think the menu was a groundbreaking. There was a groundbreaking item on the menu. I mean, the salmon Philly was cool. You don't really see that a lot of places, or most places. The mumbo wings was definitely excellent, because outside of DC, that's something you really can't get anywhere.
Oh, he could have had a limited. Excuse me. He could have had a limited menu because of COVID.
The lemon pepper. So he's giving you lemon pepper wet, which is.
It was salty to me. I mean, it was good, but it was salty.
But so most people just give you a little bit of lemon pepper, sprinkle some seasoning on the top. But he's giving you lemon pepper sauce. So that's definitely, you don't see that anywhere. And that obviously has to be homemade. Something he's making homemade too. So, that's a good solid 7. He's getting a good solid 7. I appreciate him. I'll definitely go back if I'm in the neighborhood.
When would you ever be on this side of town?
When I'm in the neighborhood, I'll definitely come back.
You have not one reason, not one, to be over here.
You don't know who I know. Who I might be trying to go see.
I'm the only person you need to go see.
If I'm ever in the neighborhood, I'll come back.
Anyways. So the tour ends on the 30th. So if you have not been to any of the restaurants that's on the list, you still have a lot of time to go and view those restaurants. And it's not just restaurants, because they have bakeries on there, the smoothie spot is on there. But you go look on their website. I think the website is called CharlotteBlackRestaurantWeek.com.
And if you're ever in the neighborhood of Nappy Chef, just send me a DM. I'll pop up.
If you want to die, you want to send Wesley a DM.
Pop up.
As always, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. And also, if you would like, you can follow us on our Instagram, The Jackson Duo. And it most like on our Instagram, we upload more pictures and videos than we do on YouTube because we only do this once a week. So we upload a lot of different stuff on there. But I think I'm going to start, I think we're going to start uploading videos twice a week, depending on time frame or whatever. But again, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. I can't even talk. Like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget that even though it's Charlotte Black Business Week, you can still send us restaurants and black businesses wherever you are, and we can come and do a review and show our support. The more businesses you guys post, the more videos you will receive. So, you give and you shall receive. All right? Okay.
And next week, we're doing a little departure from restaurants. So, it's going to be a business, and, you know, stay tuned.
Stay